Hello again, everybody. Now it's time for my second cooking tutorial with Living Like Larry. Tonight, I'm doing my girl's favorite dish on a Blackstone griddle, hibachi. Just like Tokyo Steakhouse, with all the flinging of the eggs and the fire onion. But before we go out there, I like to get my meat marinated. Some people I've seen do these, and they'll put like a whole chicken breast, boneless chicken breast on the grill and cook it and then cut it up on the grill. I like to cut my meat down to about 1-inch pieces or so, and then marinate them at least for a couple hours. Starting off, we got butchered sirloin steak, fresh from the freezer, not from the store. Let me wash my hands here, and then we'll get started. Okay, like I said, I got two steaks here. Let's cut down the small one first. Let's trim off all the fat. So throw that back here. Like I said, I just cut this into about 1-inch pieces. Nothing to it. It's just how we like ours. You can do it any way you want. That's it. I am not a professional chef. I just enjoy cooking. It's a good habit of mine. Love to barbecue. And I really like this Blackstone griddle that I got. So, that's why you're seeing so much of it. That and the girls really like it. So, there you go. Just nice little pieces of beef. Now I'm gonna bag them up and put some Worcestershire cider sauce. I can never say that word. Soy sauce and teriyaki sauce and marinate it. No special mixture, just, you know, flavor everything to how you like it. Not how I like it, how you like it. Okay, I'm gonna get these bagged up, marinated, and then we'll start on the chicken. So far, I got my steak marinating. Like I said, got that in sirloin steak, in teriyaki sauce, soy sauce, and Worcestershire sauce. And I'm not saying that anymore because I can't say it right. So my next step is chicken. I use boneless, skinless chicken breast, and I will cut them into pieces as well. As I said, some people actually cook these on the griddle and then cut them up. I like to get everything cut down beforehand. We're using steak and chicken tonight. Last time we had steak, chicken, and shrimp. You can use shrimp, you can use salmon, you can use anything you want, really. Whatever kind of meat you like. So I'm gonna cut this chicken up into some nice little pieces. Makes it easy to handle. Cooks real evenly. I'll cut that down. It just into nice little pieces. And you want to try to keep it all somewhat similar in size so it cooks rather evenly. And after I get these all cut up, I'm going to put them in a bag and marinate them as well, same way I did the steak. And I'll see you outside for the next step, the vegetables. So earlier we got the meat ready. We got your chicken marinated. We have the beef marinated. Sirloin steak, boneless chicken breast. In the meantime, we got rice with shredded carrots and peas. Now you can use any kind of white rice with this. Boil in a bag, whatever. But what you do need to know is you don't want to cook your rice and then immediately put it on the grill. It'll get mushy. So, I've started on my vegetables here. I got onion, yellow squash, and zucchini. So we'll get some more of that cut up. I just cut them into nice little pieces. veggies. Again, your zucchini, treat it just like you do the squash, and just cut it in nice little pieces. And you can cut them any size you like. We're also going to do some onion. And again, these are the vegetables that we use. You could use mushrooms, or no onion, no zucchini, no squash, any kind of vegetables that you like. There's really no certain recipe to this. This is just how we like it, so. Onion in there. Just cut them in pieces. And then the last vegetable I'm going to use is going to be some broccoli florets. We got the frozen ones this time. So you can throw them in there just like so, or you can cut them down into smaller pieces if you prefer. Like I said, you can use fresh broccoli. This time we just got the frozen. Throw them in here and thrust the veggies. And as many as you like. No certain way. And there are other stuff, like I said, we got the meat, we got the rice with the shredded carrots and the peas, we got our vegetables with the yellow squash, zucchini, broccoli florets, and onion. Also, I use minced garlic and with the vegetables once on the griddle. And we get noodles. We get these stir-fry noodles. They're pre-cooked. And we use these. You could also use top ramen noodles. You just cook them. Don't put the seasoning in. Just cook them so they're ready for the griddle. And that's it. So the next step, we're gonna move over to the griddle and cook this.
Here we are at the Blackstone Griddle again. I'm
telling you, if you don't have one of these, you really need to get one. They are nice. So we're gonna cook up the vegetables first. And a bottle of canola oil here. You can use vegetable oil, whatever oil you prefer. We use canola oil. I wanna put it down first over here for the veggies. Then I'm gonna dump these on. I have a lot of veggies. Gotta get the spatula here. Got that nice sizzle. And again, I got the Blackstone about 3/4 up here, low over here. So I'm gonna cook everything here and then I'm gonna move it over. Now, with the veggies, I'm going to put water on them to steam them. That's going to steam them.
This is also where I use my hemp garlic. Couple spoonfuls. Over here. That'll get all mixed up as I use my spatula. Yeah. You just get these veggies cooked up real good. I'm gonna add some teriyaki sauce. Get some good flavor in here. Some soy sauce. And some of this sauce, I said I wasn't gonna say anymore because I can't say it right. Worcestershire sauce. I failed miserably at that. There we go. We got some flavor in them veggies. Got some garlic. I could be like a hibachi chef. I just dump my camera person. Just to say, that did not get in her mouth. We're going to move the veggies over to the roll heat over here. Lower heat. And scrape some of this off. In there, catch pan. And next up, we're gonna add the rice. Again, more oil for the rice. Here we go. Rice, carrots, and peas. Peas like to roll all over. Rice jumps everywhere once it's cooked, if you didn't know that. It pops. You come over here and look. Rice pops. You didn't see any. But it does pop. Don't pop on me now.
I saw one.
Okay, see it pop. So with the rice, we're gonna add our sauces again. Got some teriyaki in there. It's enough so it hits everything. Soy sauce. And the sauce that shall not be named. We go heavier on the soy than the other sauces. Oh, there's the rice popping. Let it cook. Put that over. Sauces give us a real nice flavor. Next thing we have to add to the rice. To make fried rice, you do need to add eggs. I'm gonna Add a couple eggs in here. Get them all scrambled up. Got some egg in it, that rice. Ingredients over here are the noodles, the stir fry noodles. Get some oil on there. Got the noodles, bust them up a little bit in here. Oil. Yes, it looks like a lot of food, but my family likes to eat these leftovers the next day for lunch, so. And again, with the noodles. Drop the rim up with the same ingredients.
Nothing.
How's that smelling over there? I said these noodles are pre-cooked. We find them at Walmart in the Oriental food aisle. Do not take long to cook. The noodles are cooked. Slide them over here to the warm side. Stay warm. We're almost finished. Now, for the steak. Now it's been marinating about 2 hours. Throw that on here. Get the steak cooking. You can add a little bit of soy to it. So it's been marinating, so it's already got that flavor soaked into it. Now it's just cooking it up. Now the steak's pretty much done. scoot it over here to the warm area. I got the noodles off, everything's off. If my family didn't love this so much, I wouldn't have to make so much of it. And then I could actually fit everything on here and keep it over here. But I gotta move it off to make more room. And our very last ingredient. Top this off. Our marinated chicken. Marinate really good. You can add some more flavor to it if you like, or you just leave it like this. Or you don't have to marinate it at all. You can just put it on here and then add the flavor to it afterwards. While it's cooking. I personally like to marinate. So, I'm gonna wait for this chicken to cook. Then we're going to dig into a good meal. It looks like the chicken's about done. Let me cut a piece open here and see what it looks like. Oh yeah, that's done. So, got the steak off already. Let's get this chicken off. Let's give this a try. Let's try this steak. Very good. Very good. Nice and tender. Good flavor. Let's try the chicken. Hot. So, delicious. And if you look here, here's our hibachi meal for the night. Our noodles, rice, veggies, chicken, and sirloin steak. I hope this helps some of you out if you're looking to make this on your Blackstone griddle or any griddle. I say my family loves it. You know, you can make it however you want to. This is how we do it, just basic way to get started. And again, thanks for watching Living Like Larry. If you like my videos, please like and subscribe. And I'll see you the next one. Good night.